I've been doing a forensic accounting for over 30 years. And I was a forensic accountant before there was such a thing as a forensic accountant, believe it or not. That's how long ago. So a lot of people ask me, what does it take to be a successful forensic accountant? And I've put a lot of time thinking about, there's a lot of different things that make you successful as a forensic accountant. One of them is you have to think differently than everybody else, because when you go into a courtroom, the lawyers think the same, the judges, and you need to think differently, and you need to be able to show them why you are right. And the best way to think differently is, a lot of people who have multiple disabilities growing up that were not treated, they make great forensic accountants, believe it or not. Just think of the movie with Ben Affleck and the called The Accountant. The other thing is that you need to have a PhD level of understanding of business. You have to know marketing, finance, taxes. You need to know everything. And what I tell people is, what I think you should do is go to a good state school, major in accounting, graduate, get an MBA at one of the state schools, and then become a CPA, work in the field a while. But then what I always tell them is go back to an Ivy League school like Harvard, Yale, or Princeton, and go back and relearn a lot of stuff and just go through it, because you need both in order to be this, what I call a PhD level. You need both. And don't go into like an Ivy League school in the beginning, because that you need the street smarts of the state school. And if you do it this way, what I find, most of the people that I deal with who are really good at this stuff have done that path. The other one is physical stamina. And here I like to have someone who in their childhood competed in combative type sports for at least 8 years, like mixed martial arts, wrestling, football, high level soccer, really intensely played sports when they're young, because that will build the stamina they need. The last thing that someone needs is the ability to time travel. What do I mean time travel? I mean you need to go back in time and you need to travel forward in time. For example, I had a case years ago, I had to go back 80 years and figure out what happened. And what you do is you put yourself in a state of mind where you picture you're back in this company 80 years ago and what happened and why it happened, and you've got to be able to piece it together. And then you've got to travel forward and say, okay, this happened 80 years ago, this is the situation now, how does this affect the future? And these four things, think differently, PhD level of understanding, physical stamina, and time travel, usually make for a good forensic accountant. If you have any questions on this video, feel free to email me.